What is going on, everybody? It's your boy, Desk of Pens, and I am back. And I am so happy to be back. You guys have no idea, okay? I have missed you, okay? It's been way too long. I think, did I even upload last week? I'm not sure I did. But anyways, here's the situation. As many of you know, I am an aviation major, right? And what this means is a whole lot of reading. And currently I'm in this thing called ground school. And because I'm in ground school, it means a lot of study and it means a lot of work and a lot of time. I have been living at my university's library for the past 6 days. I just got back. That's not a joke. That is true. That has all happened. And so anyways, but I am going to try to upload like every Friday for like the next semester. And honestly, this will probably go on for the rest of the academic year, but please know I will try to upload. No promises, you know, just, it's just kind of the nature of the beast. Unfortunately, sometimes I gotta go slay a dragon, which is annoying, but oh well. But anyway, I am really excited for this video because this was actually, this video is dedicated to Tactical Pencil. This one's for you, buddy. A few weeks ago, he hits my lineup and he gives me a great idea. He's like, hey, I have a question. I'm like, what's up? He's like, would you ever consider making a video of the, you know, smoothest pens in like every tip size? So like, you know, 0.28 to 1.6 millimeter, like in each one of those categories all the way through, like what is the smoothest pen that you found? And like, you know, I kind of responded and I'm like, here's the situation. I know some 0.5s and I'm usually 0.7 and upward all the way up to 1.6. Now, interestingly, as a pilot, this has kind of changed and I'll explain why in a minute. But you know, I kind of said like, I'll think about it. That's actually a good idea, but I don't know if I can really do it. And he's like, yo, okay, like no problem at all, but just let me know. And I'm like, heck yeah, okay. And so I thought about it and, you know, ground started and all that. And I realized that I had to get a logbook. And in this logbook, I just need to show you guys this. Boom. As a pilot, you're doing a lot of different things, right? And remarks and endorsements. You got to write like a paragraph's worth of stuff right in this tiny little line. And let me just pull out, here's a little G2 just to kind of give you a size comparison. These suckers are small. It's very small. And I was like, well, I guess I need a smaller pen. And so with that, we are going to start our list. So in the 0.28 category, the 0.28 millimeters, and I realized that there is 0.25, and I did not know that until about 10 seconds ago. So that's my bad. That's my bad. I will do a little review on the 0.25 that I know of, which is a high-tech C that's made by Pilot. But anyway, in the 0.28 millimeters, I elected the Uniball Edge Jetstream. And here's the thing about it, right? This sucker right here, to the best of my knowledge, this is the only pen that they make in 0.28 millimeter. So, I mean, I can't really be too, like, picky and like, but honestly, being a Jetstream, it is kind of phenomenal. This does appear 2 times on this list, actually, which is kind of nice. Or, not this exact pen, but, you know, variants to it. So, anyway. But yeah, and I got it, and I wrote with it, and I realized that I loved it. And I was like, wow, that's actually kind of cool. I'm like, I didn't think that, like, a thin, like, a ballpoint pen would really impress me all that much, right? And, like, who knows, maybe one day I'll be showing you guys an extra fine or something from a fountain pen. You know, that could be kind of interesting. But anyway, so, let's see. I was counting, that's what all that humming was, and I have like 12 lines, and this is a lot more than 12 lines, so I think it's cool if I start right here. So 0.28 millimeters, that is going to the Jetstream Edge. How about that? Oh yeah, super, super cool. And the nice thing is with how tiny it is, you see that? That says how tiny. Yo, I can really write small and just get it done, you know? But something else that my flight instructor said is like, may I implore you young men, may I implore you young men to write legibly. And I'm like, oh no. I'm like, oh no. That is not going to end well. But oh well. But listen, I'm going to try. I'm serious, you guys. I'm going to give it some time, right? And I'm just going to, you know, write really, really teeny, teeny, teeny. And my handwriting is going to get a lot better. You know, you know, you know. But anyway, after the 0.28 millimeter, I realized, you know what? It would be nice to maybe go up a size, you know, just to kind of see of the 0.38 millimeter. And suddenly I realized, hang on, I do kind of want to see what some of this stuff is about. And so, you know, I was at my university store and I was kind of looking at them. And, you know, I just wrote with a couple of them and whatnot. And honestly, the one that I felt was the most, what's the word? The one that I felt was the smoothest was the Pilot G2 and 0.38 millimeter. And as you can see, Booyakasha, this is like brand new. And, you know, I have been working on it and it's actually very, very nice. So 0.38 millimeter Pilot. Yeah, it really is buttery smooth. Kind of shocks me a little bit, actually. Because, like, in other like, tip sizes, I feel like there are other competitors that honestly knock out the G2. But I don't know. I mean, I guess Pilot just kind of knew what it was doing when it was getting really, really fine. Maybe that's part of the ink formula. I'm not entirely sure, but it is very, very nice. You know, you know, you know. And for the record, in terms of smoothness, I used a number of rollerballs and gel pens and ballpoint pens. And look, this is very subjective, right? But I was trying to go just for overall smoothness, you know, just to kind of see like, okay, like this is kind of smooth. Is this smoother? No, it's not. Okay, this one's smoother. That's going to win. But yeah. And so, you know, overall, just for overall smoothness, I felt that the Pilot G2 and 0.38 millimeter compared to all the other ones that we have in 0.38, namely the Sharpie S gel, the Pentel Energel, all those guys, I felt like the G2 beat it out. I do know some people are going to disagree with me, and that's completely fine, you know? That is the beauty of YouTube. We can just disagree with each other, you know? And so, anyway, so I bought that, and then I was kind of having a look at some 0.4 millimeters because I thought, well, why not? They exist. People like them. And this, again, went to Pilot, and this is the Pilot Hi-Tech C4. Mm-hmm. I test wrote with it. Oh, my gosh. And let me just say that there is definitely a bit of a jump between these two. I didn't realize it would make all that difference, but it absolutely did. And I guess, what would this be considered? G-Tech, so this would be a gel pen. A beautiful, beautiful gel pen for that matter. And yeah, let me just go ahead and show you guys the refill, since this is a pen I have not yet reviewed. It will have its own video in due time, but you know, right now it's just fun. So yeah, so boom, here we go. 0.4 millimeter, the Pilot. Yeah, and honestly guys, it is really smooth. Like, yes, it's in 0.4, but I'm just saying, like, for a 0.4, I don't feel a lot of feedback, a little bit of vibration, but zero scratchiness, you know. And it kind of amazes me. And another thing about this is I did some research, and first up, it is refillable, which is super cool. Not only that, it is also archival ink, which I think, which honestly was a huge selling point for me. I'm like, serious. I'm like, nice. It's smooth. It's archival. That means, you know, that I can sit there all day at work doing whatever, filling out documents, you know, and not have to worry about, you know, this thing, being like splashed on and like ruining the document, or you know, some kind of theft or something, right? It's like, and that, my friend, is just beautiful. It amazes me how nice this pen is. I'm like, wow, mwah, beautiful. I love you. Cool. And so yeah, and so and also the fact that it's in 0.4 means it's just gonna last like that much longer, and that's just like, that is just the value behind these kinds of things. And so, you know, I definitely recommend it, and I cannot wait to, you know, do a more in-depth review and just kind of like show this to you guys and all that. And so, yeah. So, yeah. Up next is a rollerball. Well, rollerball, but it's retractable. I don't know why they call it like a gel roller. That just doesn't make sense to me. Maybe it's also meant to be some kind of weird hybrid thingy. But honestly, like, I 0.5 took a minute. Because honestly, like, it was kind of between this one and like another one that I've also reviewed that I thought was really smooth. But as I kept writing with them and as I kept breaking them in, I had to once again give this to Pilot. They're going 3 for 3. And I had to give it to the Pilot Precise V5, which is extremely good. You know, extremely good. Not only that, but extremely smooth. Yeah. Oh my gosh. It just, oh goodness. You see, and this also is just an amazing jump. You know, just like feeling the overall smoothness behind it. Pilot Precise V5. And this is a needle point, like this one and this one. And I mean, I guess technically it's conical, but it feels more needle-y to me. So boom, needle point, you know. But again, these needle points honestly do a really, really good job with just kind of making you feel like, oh man, that's actually really, really good. And this is a retractable, boom, 0.5 Pilot Precise V5. Really beautiful pen. This was a gift from my dearest mother. Thank you, ma mère. Je t'aime beaucoup. And so, here's the refill right there. I have been doing some work on it. I've been meaning to write with it more, but you know, I have a couple of different pens that I honestly just enjoy working with. But let me tell you, man, like this is just a really, really smooth one, a really nice one. And honestly, I know that a lot of you already know what I'm talking about, you know, but for real, it's like this is just a great, great, great pen. And there's a lot of different like variants to it just in terms of looks. I kind of like this weird purple turquoise thingy that they have going on. I feel like it kind of gives it a little bit of a personality. But if you don't like that, you can go a little more, you know, just kind of plain, kind of just a nice professional, not trying to, you know, give any weird bells or whistles, just this Precise V5. So, you know, super, super fun. Cool. Okay. There we go. Cool. Alrighty. On to 0.7. Now, 0.7 had a lot of competitors. 0.7 might just be arguably one of the most popular tip sizes. You know I've seen pens that go 0.5, 0.7, and 1.0, and then it cuts and they're done. It's just done, right? And so there were a lot of people who I was writing with, and there were a lot of different ones where I'm like, this is really nice. No, this is really nice. But, you know, I was trying to be as objective as possible, and I was like, this one is the smoothest. Like, I had to give it to it. You guys already know what it is, the Pentel Energel. And I have the American flag version. I also have this this metal alloy one, but honestly, like, aside from some of the ones that we're going to get up into when we get really bold with it, I just, you know, I just had to, I just wanted to keep it more plastic, just to kind of, just because, like, what am I trying to say here? I wanted to keep it, like, a little more plastic, just because, like, in general, these are, like, a lot cheaper and stuff, and I do think that a lot of people will appreciate that. Not only that, though, but the majority of pens that I was kind of able to deal with, they were all more plastic-made, right? So, you know, like, this competed against the Uniball 207++. It competed against the Sharpie S-Gel, the G2, just all of these different ones. And I didn't want to take the Pentel Energel alloy and compare it against like a G2. I just felt like that wouldn't be fair. I'm like, no. I just kind of want to, you know, focus a little less on the weight and a little more on the ink type of thing, just to see how the ink is going to respond, even when it doesn't have that extra weight that kind of helps pull it down a little bit. So anyway, yeah, it just shocks me just how smooth this really is. It's like, geez. Mm-hmm. So Pentel killed the Pilot. Pentel Energel. Uh-huh. And I will be doing a little video on the American flag one. Why not? Maybe I'll save it for next year. Nah. Why not? I'll just I'll take it and I'll be comparing it with the Pentel Energel as well, which I think will be really, really fun. So I know what you guys are thinking. Okay, Desk. We have done 0.28 through 0.7. Now we're just going to jump, right? And we're going to go right into 1.0. Oh, no, 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 no. This is where you're wrong, my friend. We are not going to jump. We are going into the Uniball. Boom! Vision Elite and 0.08. I just... oh, we're doing 0.8. And folks, I could not ignore this one. It is just beautiful. It is amazing. I love it so much. And I'm just like, this is like, honestly... This is my favorite red pen. Controversial, I know, but it's true, you know, and it's just beautiful. It's a beautiful pen. It's a great, great rollerball. Let me make sure the camera work is good. Rollerball. And I honestly just love it, and I support it, and I think it's just amazing, and it makes me oh so happy. It just amazed at how cool it really is, you know, and like, oh, dang it. There are these Vision Elites in blue-black. I need to grab them. I need to make a video with them because, man, it's so fun. Okay, cool. So that is the 0.8, and honestly, guys, it is just underrated with how nice that thing is. It shocks me. It genuinely shocks me, right? And so, okay, so now we're going to be going up a little more to 0.9 millimeter. And, you know, I will explain that when I come to it, but let's not do that yet. Okay, so, boom. In 0.9 millimeter, I had to go with the Fisher Space Pen in a fine black point, right? Because the fine black, these guys are all 0.9, which is kind of nice. I used to think that they were 0.7, and then I started comparing, and I'm like, wait a minute, that is not right. And then I realized, oh no, this is 0.9 millimeter. I'm like, that's super, super cool, you know? Like, you know how in like the US we have all these like big cars, these like oversized cars and stuff? Well, you know, Fisher Space Pen, as I'm sure you all know, made in America, and our version of a fine is like well beyond, you know, any of these. It just trumps these. It's so funny. I'm like, yo, I love that. Mm-hmm. So here we go, 0.9 millimeter Fisher Space Pen. And I just think that's beautiful, you know. Now, candidly, you guys, I actually didn't really find any of the, I didn't find any other 0.9 millimeters, right? So one might argue, oh, you know, you didn't need to include this. That's kind of unfair. This is the only guy who really had that category. At the same time, though, I feel like it's another fun option that people can, like, think about, you know? And so, again, it's like, I could understand how some people might be like, nah, but I'm like, yeah, and that's just what it is. So anyways, 1.0. This is a big fight. There are a lot of people trying to win me over. A lot of great pens out there telling me that, you know, that they were the one for me. But ultimately, in terms of smoothness, had to give it, you know, the click to our Uniball Jetstream. You know, this is the wonderful RT. I have had this one the longest. I have a pack of like 12 of these. I've been giving them out, though. I don't know how many I have left. But anyway, as you can see, there's a little crooked clip right here. This is how I know it's the oldest, because one time I was coming out of the bathroom and it was clipped onto my jeans, and the door handle snagged it, and it kind of just pulled it back, and I was like, ah, dang it. But anyway, 1.0 millimeter Uniball Jetstream. The Edge and this RT Jetstream, this retractable Jetstream. This is like literally what it's called. It should be renamed to the rubber body, but like on Amazon and even on Uniball's website, they call this exact model the RT. And I'm like, okay. I'm like, it's not the most creative uni, but you know, it is kind of amazing, and I can appreciate that. Now, here's the other thing, though. This is where it gets kind of weird, because even though I agree that this is, you know, the smoothest ballpoint, and while I also think that it is the smoothest between all the gel and all the other ones, and I will get into that in a minute for as to why, even though I think it's really smooth and really good and all that, I'm still kind of favoring the Pilot Acro Ball. You know, it's not on this list, unfortunately, you know, but man, like, I love writing with this thing. As you can see, I've kind of made some work on it, right? I have a couple Acro Balls. I've gone through like a million refills. I love them. They're so nice, You know, and I just, man, these pilots, I've bought so many pilots. It's like I own the Air Force, and it's just like, it's just cool, you know? And like, yeah. And so even though this one is smoother, right? And even though this formula is honestly objectively better, for some reason, this kind of gives a little more grip to the page. And I feel like I get a better writing experience with it. Whereas this one, even though it is insanely smooth, and look, again, you do need to give it credit because, you know, the ink is archival. You can send documents with it. You can't necessarily do that with the Echo Ball. But even though it has all these like really good features to it, like sometimes it just feels a little bit slick. You know, like I feel like my handwriting gets a little bit worse the more when I'm writing with it. You know, sorry, I just had to make that clear that this is RT and yeah. But, you know, my handwriting does kind of fly out the window a little bit to the point where like I have kind of ordered some like 0.7 millimeter refills. But it is still on the list because, again, if you guys are going for just objectivity, like what is it? What do you think it is? It's like, I feel like it's this, you know, and I also feel like it beats out a lot of like gel pens because honestly, I feel like gel pens don't quite do it. Yeah, well, they do it, but for some reason in 1.0, I feel like I have a better experience with ballpoints just in terms of overall smoothness, you know, like gel pens. I feel like they thrive down here. I feel like they do a really good job down here, right? But I don't feel like they do well up here. You know, I think this is where they start to struggle just a little bit because, bit of a spoiler, though true, the rest of these are all ballpoint pens, you know? And if you're not into BPs, you can click away. But I'm just telling you that now. So anyway. So, oh, hang on a moment. Back at it again. Okay, sorry about that. I was just reordering pens just to make sure I knew which one was what. The next one is our beautiful, boom, Fisher Space Pen. And this is our amazing brass. And this is in a medium black. And the medium black is a 1.1 millimeter, which I think is just kind of incredible. And this is the Cap-O-Matic and the beautiful brass and stuff. I have been meaning to get around to reviewing this thing. It's been in a lot of videos, a lot of shorts. And I just haven't gotten around to it, but I will, because it's such a nice pen. So, 1.1, oh yeah, that's so smooth. I'm sure you can imagine what 1.3 is going to be. Fisher Space Pen. Boom, there we go. Booyah. And that's just something that I think is amazing. I absolutely love this thing. It is, you know, like, Fisher Space Pen just has a certain beauty to it, you know, like a lot of American ingenuity went in here. I think that, you know, it's such a good performing, like, refill and stuff. And like, honestly, if somebody like said to me, this desk, this is the only pen you can use for the rest of your life, I'd be completely fine with that. I'd be like, okay, this is what it is. I'm like, I'm going to budget for my refills. They're about $8. Okay, and then I'm just going to take care of this puppy right here. And the nice thing, too, is that when you get something in brass, when you get something in, like, Cerakote, of which they have many options in brass and Cerakote for a good number of models, right? Like, scratching it and stuff, you don't have to worry because it kind of just adds on to its character, you know? Like, this brass in one of the shorter reels and stuff, this brass right here was very, very polished and very, very nice and beautiful, like right out of the box. But over time, it's patinaed and it's kind of just taken on like a character of its own. And like, honestly, like even after patinaing, it continues to do that. And I just think that's really, really cool, you know? And so it makes me just insanely happy just to see it. And so, yeah. So yeah, but anyway, we're talking about the smoothness, not the pen. I got totally sidetracked. Sorry about that. Let's go to 1.2 millimeter. Zebra. Z-Grip Flight. You know, honestly, this pen, not exactly my favorite of all the hybrid inks. While I do appreciate Zebra just for all the great products that they give us, and while they are a great brand, of their hybrid ballpoints, I don't know why, but they don't really stand out to me. Like, they are very smooth, they are very good, but I feel like there's just other hybrid ballpoints out there I think that there are other non-hybrid ballpoints. That's what I mean to say. Sorry, guys. I feel like there's other non-hybrid ballpoints out there, that can do a better job compared to the Z Grip. Or no, just compared to Zebra's emulsion line in general. You know, that goes for the Z Grip, that goes for the Zebra Blend Pen, just like all that. But again, if you like it, by all means, knock yourself out. If you can handle this grip, I think the grip is okay. But honestly, it does feel, for a rubber grip, it doesn't feel the most grippy in the world. But like, if you like the look of this pen, if you kind of just enjoy 1.2 millimeter, and if you're like, you know what, Desk, I don't care, I'm just going to enjoy my life with this thing, by all means, knock yourself out, okay? I'm not trying to like hate on it too much, but you know, it's just not like, it's just not the end all be all for me, you know? But anyway, but still insanely smooth, you know? It's like, whoosh, 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 you know? Yeah, so anyway, little bit of smudging, but oh well. Okay, let's go to 1.3 millimeter, and guess what's coming back? The Fisher Space Pen in bold this time. And for the record, with these Fisher Space Pen models, some of them, yeah, see how messed up this is. I've written with this thing so much because this is my only bold. Yeah, black bold refill right there. And that's in a 1.3 millimeter. But real quick, just so you guys know, in regards to the Fisher Space Pen models that I'm showing you right now, usually, a stock Fisher Space Pen comes with this right here, just a medium black or maybe a medium blue. One time, I got a Fisher Space Pen that said it was a medium black, but it was a medium blue. And honestly, I was kind of flattered by it. I'm like, ooh, a defect. I like this. But anyway, yeah, but this sucker right here is what it usually comes with. Unless you go onto the website and you specify, no, I want like a medium blue or a bold blue or a fine blue, or, and then they have a bunch of other colors, purple and green and red and others that I just have never really seen before, if I'm just being honest with you. But anyway, yeah, but like, this is like the stock thing that you're usually gonna get, right? Unless you have a defect like me, or unless, you know, maybe on Amazon it like specified like, no, this isn't blue. You buy this, you get a blue pen. It's like, okay. Yeah, but anyway. So yeah, this is the beautiful backpacker, the Fisher Space Pen backpacker. And again, originally it came in a medium black. And for a long time, actually, I was writing with it in a fine blue. But that is no longer the case. I was like, you know what? I kind of want it in the nice black Fisher Space Pen. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And this is just insanely smooth for 1.3 millimeter. I have to appreciate it. Yeah. And, you know, I just think this is a really, really nice refill. It's a really great pen, and it just makes me oh so happy. Let's go. Alrighty. Let's move on to the next one. This is the Schneider Slider Rave. Now, 1.4 millimeter is German territory, right? So we're talking Faber-Castell. We're talking Schneider, we're talking Schmidt. Well, no, some Schmidts actually aren't that bold, but others are. And, you know, Lamy, I think, has some options there. In general, you know, it is more German territory going on, right? And ultimately, I had to go with this one, because even when I write with it, you will see a little bit of skipping, which is unfortunate. But honestly, it's not too bad of skipping. And it is insanely smooth. It is very just buttery smooth, really, really nice. And, this pen right here, I think when I bought it, it cost me like $6 or something. With that said, I got it at this one shop where I just kind of wanted to like get it. And I was like, ooh, this is kind of cool. I kind of like the way that, that it writes. Truth be told though, I probably could have just, you know, gotten it in bulk for like a little bit cheaper per unit price. At the same time though, having all the pens that I do, I realized I don't need another one. So it's like, I could have gotten this for $6 or paid 20 and gotten four, three of which I may not really use. And well, anyway, I could kind of go on about it, but you know, the way to grab this, I would say, would be like on Amazon, a very, very smooth pen. And yeah, you see, this is just really, really good. Yeah, Schneider. Slider Rave XB. Beautiful, beautiful refill. Very, very nice. Very, very good. Yeah, and so the last pen that we're going to review, actually, is the one that is in 1.6 millimeter. And that, my friend, is the Bic Crystal. I love dropping them on the page. It's so much fun. So this is 1.6, and there are some variants to it. There's this other, like, kind of clicky one. I don't actually have those on me, but candidly, if I'm just keeping it real, I kind of prefer this crystal because, like, I feel like this right here, like here. So see this refill, right? So you kind of notice this edge right here all around and then some stuff right up here. You click that in. I feel like that really stabilizes it. Like, I actually think that's kind of a genius design. And I realize no one else is really going to do that because, you know, Bic did that. And they're like, no, we have to be cool and different. But nah, man, like, Bic, you guys, this just, you know, I just gave it a little kiss, you know, because I'm like, this is just a really, really good pen, you know, Bic Crystal. Yeah, mm-hmm. And for how broad it is, I really think that this ink just really pours out and just, oh my goodness, it's just, it's amazing. Extra broad. I'm pretty sure that's what this is called, or extra bold, geez. Boom. So yeah, so that's kind of my list right here. Yeah. And for the record, as you guys know, I do have my Mont Blanc Meisterstück. Here's the thing. That thing is super smooth and super soft. And I would have put it on here, but I did all of this research looking for what tip size it was, and I couldn't find it. I was like, what is it? Like, I kept looking up, like, Mont Blanc bold refill tip size, and, like, I kept getting all these, like, different answers and stuff, and I was like, come on, and, like, I know it's either 1.0 or it's, like, 1.3 or 1.4 or something, but, yeah, like, whatever it is, it would have replaced any one of these, you know, the Jetstream, the Slider Rave, because, like, look, honestly, Mont Blanc ballpoint pens, I think I've said it before, if not, I'm saying it here, and I'll say it again, they are the best pens in the world. I've said it. They are the best pens in the world. I've said it again. The ballpoint pens, anyways. I feel like their ballpoints are some of the best ever. I have written with some of their fountains, but in all honesty, I wasn't impressed. And Rollerball, there's definitely better out there. Because those Rollerballs, they might be smooth, but they're still smoother. And man, do they smear. But anyway. But Mont Blanc aside, all of that. Let's move this out the way, and then let's look at our beautiful. So just to reiterate, and I'm going to go by kind of quickly here, the Bic Crystal, the Schneider Slider X-Rave, a Fisher Space Pen 1.3, a Zebra Z-Grip Flight in 1.2, another Fisher Space Pen in 1.1, a Uniball Jetstream in 1.0, a Fisher Bullet Stylus in 0.9 millimeter. A Uniball Vision Elite Love You in 0.8 millimeter, the Energel in 0.7, the Precise V5 in 0.5, the Pilot Hi-Tech C in 0.4, the G2 in 0.3, and the Uniball Edge in 0.28. So these are them. These are the pens. I'm like, oh my goodness, I love them. And legit, it is so, so fun, and it is just so amazing, and, you know, this has been a really fun video to create, and my voice is kind of, like, gone a little, but honestly, I've been looking forward to it, guys, like, seriously. And so you guys are great. And before we wrap up here, just some announcements, maintenance, just to kind of talk. So, you know, just to review, every Friday, I am going to try and upload a video. I also saw that I was at 469 subscribers as of today. I'd just like to thank you all for that. I'd like to thank all the people who have been here a while, and I'd like to welcome all of the new channel members. You guys are great. It is so much fun. For my 500 subscriber mark, I have an announcement. I am going to be showing you guys my Grail pen. You know, after kind of searching around for a lot of different fountain pens, there was just this one that kind of stuck out to me, and I was like, I gotta grab that sucker, and I have grabbed it, and it's kind of awesome, and, you know, so I am really excited for that video. This Grail pen is one that I have not mentioned on this channel before. There are some other big videos that are coming up. I recently got this cool vintage Parker 51 in 14K. And I do want to do a video with that. Honestly, though, there's just going to be more editing involved with it because I am thinking about, like, kind of writing an essay on it, on why it's so cool and, like, all that. That's not my Grail pen, though. This one is a different one. Definitely a controversial pick, if you will. But anyway, I'm excited, and yeah. So, yeah. Other than that, I don't have any other announcements. And, yeah, this is your boy. Desk of Pens, thanking you all, telling you all that I love you all, because I do. This is fun. And yeah, now I'm signing off.